Hello everyone, welcome back to Mix Best TV. Hope you're having a great day. I have another one of these informal rapid fire Q&A with you guys, and this is from John Bobby. I hope I'm not butchering the name. You can read on the screen the full question. I summarize. Is it reasonable to say that we should always use the best mic that most faithfully captures everything about the sound source and then apply our EQ, etc. on the recorded track so that it best fits in the mix? All right, let's start with the first part. Wouldn't it be better to record with a transparent microphone as opposed to a colored microphone that colored the source? Yes and no. While it makes sense what John is saying, is not as straightforward, because when we pick a microphone for a given source, let's focus on vocals, for example, we don't pick a mic just because of its frequency response. So how linear it is, how linearly capture and faithfully captures the source. There are many other factors as to why we pick one specific microphone. How fast is on transient, how detailed or forgiving is, if we have problems with room reflection, what kind of rejection it has. And while some microphones do have a linear response, they can add harmonics that are pleasant and that they add something to the source. Now, when we pick a microphone, we don't necessarily need to know all the specs of the microphones and all the numbers and the frequency charts or the harmonic content and all that, because this happens naturally by trying the microphone on the source. All right, we try different microphones and one is gonna be more pleasant and sound better. Of course, this happens naturally if you have a trained ear and you have experience, because remember, it doesn't really matter how the source sound in solo, it's all a matter of how it's gonna sound on a record in the mix, right? So a producer, which is the one who should supervise that choice, and the recording engineer would be the guy that physically put the mic and press record, need to have the final product in mind when picking a microphone for a vocal by any other source. But like I said before, there are basically two school of thoughts. The engineers and producers that do exactly what John describes in the question, meaning I want to capture the source as naturally as possible, and then we'll make the choices later on in the mix, right? And I personally, for the most part, marry this school of thought, meaning I usually don't use EQ when I record vocals in particular. Other sources I might 50% of the time, but I definitely use compression when I record vocals. So that definitely not only color the sound, but it changes the natural dynamic of it. But I do this because I know how vocals are supposed to sound in a mix already. So I just make my job easier by getting ahead of time and saving myself time by compressing the vocal on the way in. Don't do it if you're not experienced, or you know, you could fuck up a good performance. I don't like to use EQ on the way in. For the most part, 90% of the time I don't, but some other engineers do. And there's really nothing wrong with it. Like I said, I don't like to do it, so I'm biased on that. And some other engineers do, because maybe they have a chain that they usually use and it works, which includes EQ or includes a colored microphone. Picking a colored microphone that doesn't have a linear frequency response could potentially solve the problems that you already know the source has. For example, the singer has particularly harsh S's or consonant, or maybe it's just very bright. You might want to use a ribbon microphone because it shaves off the top end very naturally. And it's better than using EQ because it's less processing. You capture the source, which is already in a better shape as if you used a very detailed bright mic, right? Or even flat mic, because the source is naturally unbalanced, all right? Same if you have the opposite, maybe that vocalist has a little too much low end or is a bit too tubby, so you might prefer a microphone that is a bit lighter on the low end or in the low mid range, and maybe a little bit brighter, because you know, some singers are not so open when they sing. And then, like I said, there's the question of the harmonic content. Some microphones, maybe a transformer, maybe a tube microphone, can have a pretty linear response, but it just add that richness to the source, which is still faithful. The frequency response is faithful, but it's just the sound of it is richer. And then there's the complicated, the tricky part. When we record and when we mix, we kind of fake reality. Because if you think about it, when we hear someone singing, we don't put our ear 4 inches from the mouth, which is exactly how the microphone hears and records the source. So that is very unnatural, right? Same for a guitar cabinet. When you hear a guitar cabinet, you don't put your ear in front of the cabinet, right? Where, you know, the SM57 or whatever other mic you're using is. So because of that, the choice of the microphone or microphones, I'm talking about vocals, but it could be multiple sources. We fake reality. We pick microphones that help us replicate what we actually hear in the room as close as possible once we have a recorded file. And that most times, because the way we record with a close microphone to the source might not be the most faithful, because to reproduce the way we hear things with our 2 ears, we need to fake a lot of things in studio, multiple microphones, and then even more in mixing. That's literally what we do in mixing, right? We take a raw source that is recorded up close, and then we make it spacious and we add stereo effects to make it sound like we are in the room, all right? Or, you know, in some cases we want to do something creative, but you get the point. And then there's the question of the media we're recording. We don't record on tape, we record on hard drive, and everything is super detailed, super crisp. So you might not want a microphone that really captures everything, you know? Detail is good, especially for an intimate, you know, vocal performance, but too much, it becomes too much. So you might want, you know, an in-between, like, okay, I want to be faithful to the source, but I need something that is slightly smoother, so it's more pleasant to listen to. Because sometimes the hard truth and, you know, completely faithful, it might not be so pleasant to hear. With that said, as far as EQ goes, I prefer not to use EQ. But as far as a microphone, I'm not against using a colored microphone on a given source if it matches, if it complements the source, whether it's a vocal, whether it's a snare, or, you know, a guitar cabinet. Generally speaking, I do tend to prefer fairly linear microphones that are not hyped, especially on the high end, because one very bad trend lately in the past years has been that microphone companies tend to make their microphone really bright. And that is because everything that is brighter tricks our brain and make us think that it's better for the first 15 seconds. So if you have 5 microphones and you go test these 5 microphones, at first, the first impression when you start testing all of them, the brighter one is the one that will make you go, oh wow, this sounds nice. But that's just how our brain works instinctively. Then you need to have trained ears and to understand, okay, that is brighter. That's why I'm thinking that, but is actually better than the others? You know, how's the mid-range? How's the slew rate? How fast is on transient? How, if I record with that microphone, the recording will react to the processing that I have to do in mixing. So you kinda have to foresee what is gonna be, and that requires, of course, experience. With that said, I tend to prefer. I hope this answered the question. Please, guys, check all the links in the info box down below. Leave your questions for the Q&A in the comments. If you like the video, please don't forget to leave a like. If you haven't already, go watch my artist Bella Kelly's new video, Heartbreak Motel. Subscribe if you haven't already. See you next time. Hands on my neck, hands get my throat, throat. Lift me up, up, man, take control, hope. Heart is so gone, my type. Don't you know I fall for the bad type? You play the role of an angel pretty well, but I can say you came.